Here is nothing but the hash include studio.h. Studio.h is nothing but the standard input output library function, where the printf function is defined in the studio.h header file. In the conio.h, you know, it has got a console input output library function where getch function is defined. So when in the previous program we were having printf as well as getch functions. In void main function is nothing but the entry point of every C language. So main function is to be always written with the void main. It is compulsory to write this void main function. In printf function is available to use the print data on the console. You know, console is nothing but the screen. Console is nothing but the output screen, output black screen, which is seen in the C language. So printf is the function where the output screen is there. Getch is nothing but it asks for a single character. You know, it asks for the single. If you press, it blocks the screen. But when the black screen is shown, you know, black screen, when you run the output, the program runs here. For example, this is the program which runs on the output screen, and when the complete output is shown, and when you press the space bar, the black screen closes. That function is written in the getch function. So until you press any key, it blocks the screen. So this is nothing but how we have to work with the C language. Here output of the program is hello. Since the first program where we have written studio.h, conio.h, void main, printf, we are printing hello. So by I have described you what are the details. The output which would be hello C language. So here it was written nothing but the hello C language was written over here, and that came as the output, you know, on the screen. So input output function, we are going to study now what is the input output function. There are two input output function in the C. First is printf and second is scanf. Printf is the output function and scanf is the input function. Printf is a function which is used for output. So the syntax of the printf is basically, there is a standard syntax. Now this is the function, you know, and within the angular brackets here the code is to be whatever output you want. So this is nothing but the here the double colon is there. Here's the double colon. Between these two colon you have to write whatever you want to print on the console screen. And here are the argument list. Argument list is basically, if you want to, I'll say output, if you wrote, and here in the double quotes here there is a printf function, and output is nothing but here you wrote percent d, and here is the name of the character. If you want to print C, example, C is nothing but where you have defined the value of percent d. So here the output will be changing automatically. So this is nothing but here the arguments list are there, and the format is for percentage d is integer, percentage c is character, percentage s is string, percentage f is float. Will integers are nothing but from 0 to 9. Characters are there from small a to small z, from big a to big z. These are all characters. Float we will see. We'll see all in the next slides. I'll show you on the chart all these things. So basically scanf is for input purpose, which I told you. Scanf always take the user's data, and that also has the scanf. This is the function is nothing but which has got the angular brackets, and there is a format string over there. With the help of comma there is written as argument list. So argument list is there which is closed by this semicolon. Understand it, because without semicolon you are not going to you're not be able to run that program, you know. So see the example. There are most examples are written in Java T point also. Printf scanf you can download from there. Here basic data types in C language is nothing but basic data types are integer, character, float, double. You know, these are basic. Integer I told you 0 to 9, characters from A to Z, float and double. Derived data types are array, pointer, structure and union. These are derived from basic, they are derived. So these derived data types are array, pointer, structure and union. And third type is enumeration data type, enum. In enum, you know, from Monday to Saturday comes. So these are this we can define in enum. Void data type is nothing but void, mostly comes out null, or for generating the output void data type is there. So yeah, here a basic we'll see the keywords in the next slide.